afternoon and welcome to the Employ Baltimore show. Listen, y'all, this episode is coming to you from the beautiful downtown Baltimore. This is not a virtual background. What you see in here is live and in color from the 20th floor of the 36 South Charles Street with this amazing view behind me, y'all. Listen, it's been 2 years since I've been actively in my own office, and it feels great to be back here. I was talking and yucking it up with my coworkers. The collaboration just started. We have our person that's over our community hubs, the director, Helani, is here. My director is here. My counterpart, my director, Miss Yvette Clark. My counterpart, Mr. Darrell Falls, and our wonderful assistant director, Miss McKenzie. Garvin is here, y'all. Listen, it's been live and popping down here. All right, y'all see it over my back. I need everybody to get in the comments because I'm going to give y'all our people poll question for the day. Our people's poll question is, I want you to look in my background and name some of the amazing sights that you see. Now, listen, some of this stuff is easy, but if you're as Baltimore as I am, you're going to be able to pick out some of the other stuff that's not the easy stuff. So I'm trying to see who can give me some of that other stuff that's not the easy stuff that you see in this beautiful background of mine, y'all, live and in color, downtown Baltimore. There's some amazing things happened. Yesterday, there was an announcement to launch our Train Up initiative. Of course, the Mayor's Office of Employment Development on the front lines of another great initiative. They were up on Park Heights, the old Magna Center. Ain't that, I'm dating myself with that one. But they were up there yesterday for the announcement and the press conference with our mayor, our director, Mr. Jason Perkin Cohen. Again, our assistant director, Mackenzie Garvin, was there. And y'all, this is going to be another major initiative. Y'all have seen Higher Up, and now we're about to do Train Up, where we're going to be bringing training opportunities to the citizens of Baltimore. I remember coming into this work when I was a lot younger. Old Town Mall. What's up, Brandon Scott? You see Old Town Mall? Now listen, Brandon, a real one, he can see Old Town Mall. Yes, sir. But I remember coming up in this work a long time ago when training was a huge part of what we were doing. And I'm going to tell you the difference between training and helping somebody get into a job. Training will give them a skill and in a lot of instances, certifications that will take them a long way in life. Because once you have that credential, nobody can take that away from you. Jobs can fold, jobs can close. But when we're able to get you that credential, you can take that credential and you can help yourself. Y'all know the old proverb says you can feed a man a fish and he eat for a day, or you can teach him to fish and he eat for a lifetime. This teaching and training project that's coming is designed to have a lifetime impact on the people that are going to be a part of it. So you definitely want to be following the Mayor's Office of Employment Development for all of the developments, especially if you're someone that's trying to get into training. Listen, y'all, another thing, me and my partner, Darrell Falls, have been in meeting after meeting with the new lead of our apprenticeship division, Miss Wendy. And in these meetings, we are establishing another wave of apprenticeship where the Mayor's Office of Employment Development is connecting the businesses that have apprenticeship opportunities to the residents of the city of Baltimore. Listen, y'all, we have been in meetings with Bluestone Communication. We are currently talking to Maryland Environmental Services. There are businesses where people in the city of Baltimore, many people in neighborhoods of color, have been disenfranchised from the apprenticeship process. But we are bridging that gap and closing that gap. And Miss Wendy is leading the charge with her team, myself and Darrell, and everybody else that's a part of the team, bringing everything to the table to make sure that this is an amazing opportunity for everyone who wants to get involved. I need y'all to be making sure that you're watching this page, watching everything that's going on, so that you are able to be right at the front of the line. Listen, apprenticeship is not just about young people, maybe fresh out of high school. If you're that person that's been working that job for the last 4 or 5 years, and the most you've seen is a 25 cent, 50 cent increase, apprenticeship differs because you know up front what your career path is going to be and how your money is going to change over the course of a few years. One of them, you're starting out at $15 an hour, and in a matter of 3 years, you're making $30 an hour, right? I need y'all to make sure that you stay plugged in if you are interested in seeing this growth. I want to also talk to you about some of our upcoming employment initiatives. On the 17th, we're going to have a virtual job club where we're bringing several employers to the table. You'll see the flyer on my personal Facebook page and Instagram, as well as the Mayor's Office of Employment Development Facebook page. It has a link on there for you to register. You definitely don't want to miss it because it's going to have four dynamic employers. The U.S. Postal Service has opportunities available. They're going to be at the Eastside Career Center on the 16th. On the 21st, they're going to be at the Northwest Career Center. And then, no, I got it wrong. On the 21st, they're going to be at the Employment Connection Center. And then on the 23rd, they're going to be at the Northwest Career Center. You definitely want to make sure that you are plugged into these events. These opportunities start at around $19 an hour, and they are geared around and designed to making sure that Baltimore City residents get into these federal opportunities. One of my sons who have maximized every opportunity in Baltimore City's Mayor's Office of Employment Development came into our YO program. He's not my natural son, but I took him under my wing and mentored him. He came into the Youth Opportunity Program, got in our YH2O, got out of that opportunity. He got a job working in the water department. He just recently transitioned out of that position after about 3.5-4 years of working in that industry into the post office. He's now in the federal government working as a mail carrier in the post office. Listen, y'all, it's all about career pathing. On the 16th of April, we are going to be hosting an event at the South Baltimore Employment Connection Center. That's right. That's the new name, and I got it all out. The South Baltimore Employment Connection Center. Bill Cons is going to be down there hosting another opportunity, and it's going to be with M. Louise Construction. You're going to see that flyer coming up on my personal Facebook page, on the mayor's office Facebook page. And we are looking to hire a lot of people because there are a lot of opportunities with M. Louise Construction. They're located right down in the South Baltimore area near Brooklyn Curtis Bay area. So it's accessible to everybody or anybody that would be interested in these opportunities. Y'all listen, y'all know what we say. If you are looking for an opportunity, the Mayor's Office of Employment Development is looking for you because we have such a great focus on bridging any gaps between opportunity in Baltimore and Baltimore City residents. I'm going to say it again. We are focused on bridging any gaps between opportunities in Baltimore and residents of the city of Baltimore. So you want to get connected to all of our centers, our Northwest Career Center located on the third floor of Mondawmin Mall, our Westside Youth Opportunity Center located at 1510 West Lafayette Avenue, our Employment Connection Center located in South Baltimore Employment Connection Center located at 1410 Bush Street. We have three community job hubs. One is, we have five now. Wow. Five. I just spoke to Helani today. We have five community job hubs. The three that I can call off to you right now is My Brother's Keeper, located on Frederick Avenue. We have the Sponsored Corps Community Work Center, located at Fulton Avenue and Fayette Street. And then we have our Govan Center, or a Gecko, over on York Road. Y'all, we have our premier, say it with me, one of the premier American job centers, which is over on 3100 East Madison Avenue. That's the East Side Career Center. And then we have our Workforce Reception Center. The Workforce Reception Center is by referral only because that's a partnership that we maintain with the Department of Social Services. So you have to be referred there. But any of those other locations, and I will have, matter of fact, I'm going to get Helani to come on this show. Helani, Mike Wells, we're going to talk about this expansion because I just heard today that we're opening two more. I do know that one of the new ones is Our Daily Bread. I just can't remember the other one. I don't have no notes in front of me, y'all. I need to do better with that so that I can remember. But We're going to get Helani to come on here. This expansion is great because on top of the two that we have, that now puts us at 5 community access points right in the neighborhoods where you live, we're adding 2 more. One of them is going to help with our amazing ESL population in Baltimore. We have a whole lot of English as a second language citizens in Baltimore that are great Baltimoreans that are looking to work, and we're being real deliberate in our delivery of services to the diversity that is the great Baltimore City. Y'all see it again downtown. I can't see the comments. I don't know, but I hope y'all are in the comments, lighting it up, talking about the amazing attractions that you see behind us. That was a whole lot. But that still ain't the best part of what we're here to do today. We are here today to talk to two amazing people. One of them, we call her our MOED cousin because she works on the state side. This amazing young lady is a workforce machine. That's right. I said it. She's a machine. The amount of opportunities and connecting points that she shares with us is incredible. I'm telling you, my email is flooded with different opportunities for me to connect with businesses, to connect with organizations and groups that are doing workforce development work that helps us to bridge that gap between Baltimore City residents. She is just an awesome, awesome member of our team. And I want to bring her on right now. I'm talking about from the Department of Labor Licensing and Regulation, the one and the only Miss Roseanne Fish. Roseanne, thank you for joining the Employee Baltimore show today. How you doing?
Shoo. After that introduction, I am wonderful. You just put me up on a pedestal. I tell you, I put him on Steve
Harvey. If they ever you want me to host Apollo, I will do it.
You got me over here ready to quit my job and go into apprenticeship. So you're very inspirational.
Listen, it's amazing the work that we get to do. And you are a real true frontliner in this work. I tell people all the time, workforce development is its own thing. You can't particularly come from another field, even if you were successful in that and come into workforce development, because this is really a God calling and it's life-changing work. Tell the people a little bit about you and how you come to this place in your career doing workforce development.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. And what you just stated is absolutely true. I'm a millennial, and true to my generation, I have various experience in my background. I've jumped around from bookkeeping and recruiting and basically all the different jobs that I've had and education that I've picked up through experience has led me to this point where I can actually put it all together and use the recruiting experience, my HR experience, even bookkeeping in calculating, helping employers with, working out pay rates and things like that. It really has all come together to this point that I'm at right now. I genuinely know and feel that I am exactly where I'm meant to be right now in my career. And that's an awesome feeling. And I love that the work that we do gets to help other people get in that same position as well.
It's amazing to be able to do this work pretty much above anything else that I've ever done in my life. And for me, it's a little different. More than 20 years of my still kind of young life, I have done this work. But talk a little bit about what happens when you know you've made that impact of either helping a business, because we have the dual purpose. We're not just the people that help customers that are in need, helping that business meet their workforce need or that customer that's in need of an opportunity. I'm sharing the show, y'all, right now. So that's why I'm looking down.
All good. So yeah, and I actually, like, I was over here listening, taking notes. What you said about bridging the gap is exactly, that's our main goal as business consultants and workforce consultants. So as Marvin mentioned, I work with the business team, working with employers in Baltimore City who have recruitment needs, workforce training needs, apprenticeship, as he mentioned, and also when they're laying off, and we'll get into that a little bit more later, but we work with businesses that have needs, have career openings. They need assistance getting recruiting, which is a big need right now. But we also have the job service side of the house, which are individuals that work with those who are looking for work, or they want some type, you know, maybe they want to go into healthcare and they need a CNA, GNA, or they want to become a truck driver and they need to get that CDL. We have individuals that work with those folks to help get them trained up or help them look for work, update their resume, all basically everything that you need to become career ready. And the beautiful part of it is that my side of the team, business services, works with the job seeker service individuals. And we try to bridge the gap. We try to put that puzzle piece in where in the exact shape that's missing in the puzzle. So, and I can tell you, when we're working with our career navigators, if you are working with a career navigator, you have a leg up against any other competition, because when that career navigator refers you to us and we refer you to an employer that we're working with, not to brag, but we got a lot of clout with these employers, you know, a referral that comes
from. I love it. Brag all you want, because it's
exactly.
The truth.
Exactly. We have great relationships with the employers in Baltimore, and they are going to look at your resume if we send it over to them. They're going to put you right on the top of the pile of any other applicants online. They're going to look at you first. So definitely, if you're not connected, get connected, because that's just one of the benefits of working with
us. I've been telling people for years that the relationships that we build cuts out a lot of the red tape, and it gives you an access point to that business that you may not have otherwise. I don't want to circle the wagons. You have bought in a PowerPoint presentation that we're going to share and talk a little bit more to help inform our audience. Now, I'm going to let you know I'm really informal as a host. I might tell you, if you hear me say stop the press, that may not have seen something that I need us to reiterate, because we want to make sure that people are getting these great opportunities to access amazing opportunities here in the city of Baltimore.
Awesome. So it is, and thank you to Katanya and everyone in the background who
absolutely
is,
I normally shout her out when we're coming on, but I was trying to get all that information in. Y'all put some hearts in the comments and thumbs up for our amazing producer, Miss Katanya Lester, the producer, the booker. She does all of those things.
Yes. Thank you. So that's just an introductory slide showing that I work for the Maryland Department of Labor, Division of Workforce Development and Adult Learning. This is just our mission and vision statement, which guides us in the work that we do. But like Marvin said, it really is a calling. You've got to have a certain heart for this work. Yes, there are a lot of benefits working for the government, great benefits and perks and things like that. But you have to have a servant's heart. You have to have that desire to serve the individuals and the citizens of Maryland and the businesses too, and have that desire to really make those connections. So, but yeah, all in all, here's the mission and vision statement. I'm not going to read it to you because that's a pet peeve of mine. I don't like when people read off their slides, but it is there for you to see for anyone. And the work that we do is to support the economic stability of our state. And again, making those connections, making sure that everyone that is looking for work is able to find work, and not just a job, but a job that is going to fulfill them, is going to pay them enough to be able to pay their bills, you know, sustainable wages. We put in some work. So, we can move on to the next slide, please.
Yeah, and we have changed that language. We used to say a living wage, but now we call it a family sustainable wage, guys, because you may be the breadwinner in your household. And with all due respect for people who do that work, we want to make sure that people are able to support their family. So we do a lot of advocating around wages.
Yes, thank you. And that's one of our, that's another one. I didn't even put that on here, but that's another part of our job as business consultants. We have access to what is called labor market information. And let me tell you, we have analysts that this is their full-time job. We have a whole department of data analysts that are constantly crunching numbers, calculating percentages, and they let us know, you know, what industries are hiring, which industries are laying off, what is the going rate for this occupation, that occupation, what type of training is needed. Like, they put it all out there, and they don't just give us a chart with data on it. They'll actually make it pretty, like give us a pie chart or a graph, or, you know, where it's easy to see where the big green area is or the big red area. And we share this information with employers, whether they're looking to expand into Maryland or grow their business, or even if they're just hiring and they're struggling and they don't understand why, we can pull that up and say, you know, what rate are you paying? Well, let's look and see what your competition is paying. That can be a big that can really ignite them to go in the right direction and to then not struggle as much to get help to have applicants. So labor market information is a big deal. What I usually tell people, just to kind of sum it up, we wear a lot of hats, not going to lie. I could sit here all day and talk about what we do and still have more to talk about tomorrow. But essentially, when I work with employers, it's usually for three main functions. And that is, they're either, they need help recruiting talent. They have talent, but they need to train them up. Maybe they want to get them certified so that they can be promoted or take on more duties or responsibilities, be qualified for a pay rate increase, something like that. And I also work with employers who are laying off or downsizing, closing their doors. We don't just want to send those folks to file for unemployment. Of course, we do help them with that, but we also help them find other job opportunities. Again, not to keep sound like a broken record, but we're working with all the employers in Baltimore City. So when we have one laying off over here, we can then say, well, you know, these workers have these skills, this background, this employer over here is looking for somebody with that. So we're always trying to make that connection. And as part of our job in the recruitment part, we are, like Marvin mentioned at the beginning, we have several dates coming up for different job fairs, recruitment events. I'm so glad that we are finally able to get back in person.
Yes.
This virtual thing is great, and it was a lifesaver during the pandemic. And I'm sure it's not going to go away completely, but I can't tell you how great it has been to be face to face with individuals again and actually talk in person. It's great. We also share information about the Maryland Workforce Exchange, which is kind of like Indeed or Career Builder, but it's our state secure database where employers can post jobs in there for free. There's no charge. It's all tax funded. And then on the other side of the house, the job seekers are able to post their resumes, and they can also seek, you know, work, do work searches in there, as the employers can also perform a search and pull up resumes when they have an opening that they're looking to fill. We also share their job opportunities on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram. I don't know if they've gotten to TikTok yet, but the state and city have really upped our game during the pandemic to make sure that we were still serving the needs of our employers and our job seekers. And we got up on the technology with the social media. So we do some marketing, creating flyers, blasting them out, promoting them. And again,
some marketing.
A lot.
Rose, if I was to begin to tell the people how many flyers I get from you in 1 week, you remind me of a person that we had. She was one of my favorite people in workforce development. And she actually worked on your side too. Ms. Lisa Nash.
No one yes.
could blast you with opportunities like Lisa.
Yes. I try to get them all in one email, but it's an email that's like this long. So
it's worth it.
Yes. But, you know, as we've said, at the heart of everything we do is always trying to make those connections, the job seekers and the employers that have opportunities. We're constantly trying to make them the connections. And when there is a gap, we have training in between to bridge that gap and to take someone that is working, looking for work, but maybe not qualified for this job, to someone that is looking for work and is qualified for that job.
One of the great things that came out this pandemic is, and yes, I said pandemic, is a lot of collaboration, greater levels yes. of collaboration. And people were kind of, because it leveled the playing field and helped everybody to understand that we're all needed on the front lines to do this work. And I love that you're talking about this sharing space that we have, because if you're going to do this work now, you got to be tied in.
Right. And it's too much to try to do on our own. If I didn't have my partners at the mayor's office, I would not, one, I'd be, even crazier than I already am. I rely on you all just as much as you rely on me. We have a beautiful partnership, partnering to assist businesses. When I have somebody that needs a service that, you know, either we is not our specialty or whatever, I can refer them over to MOED and vice versa. You know, if they need a training or something like that, we have a great relationship. And I appreciate that very much, because that's not always the case when different tiers, levels of government try to work together. But we do. We share information. We share resources. I want the rest of the MOED team to know everything that I know, because we all think differently, and somebody might put ideas together that I hadn't thought of, or they might know something that I didn't. And you know, it's all about serving the businesses and the job seekers to the best of our ability. So I love to share the wealth, share the information, share the work, work smarter, not harder.
Absolutely.
So we can move on to the next slide, please, Ms. Catania. This is, so I'm going to move into some of the current job opportunities with the state. I believe they're going to be coming up in the ticker at the bottom, so keep your eyes peeled for that. I apologize. I realize this is very small now that I'm looking at it, but I'll tell you about it. So one of the opportunities that we have right now, listen up, anyone that's looking for remote or hybrid, this might be for you. It's a state job, working for the same department that I do with the Maryland Department of Labor. And this is in our dislocation unit. So this, as I was mentioning earlier, we work with employers that are laying off. That's dislocation, as we call it. They are looking for someone who can assist in data entry processing when an employer sends us a notification, which is called a WARN, stands for Worker Adjustment and Retraining Notification. We like to shorten everything in the government.
So we call them, it's too much to say most times.
Right. I have to remember always to, like, they just can't just spout out these things. I have to explain what they are. But you would basically be processing these WARN notifications that come in when an employer notifies us that they are laying off, and putting that into our system, which then notifies the staff that needs to respond to that, which is called a rapid response, which again is part of my job duties. So this is a lot of behind the scenes working on the computer. I believe it's either 2 days in the office and 3 days remote, or it's 3 days in the office and 2 days remote. I can't swear by it, but you can definitely find out more. And I can get I'll actually get this flyer over to you, Marvin and Catania, for anyone that's interested, or I believe Catania is going to post my email towards the end. You can always email me and I can get this flyer out to you. It also has the email address where you can send your resume to apply for the position.
You can send that resume to clester@oedworks.com.
There you go.
All roads come through Catania.
Okay, there you go. And get your resume right on top of the pile. Go through us. Another opportunity, which I didn't put on here, I apologize. We kind of put this together the other day at the last minute, but I appreciate the invite. I do my best work at the last minute anyway. But we may have an opportunity becoming available on my team doing what I do. Not sure which region yet, but it's kind of been discussed about. So stay tuned. And if you want Catania to click to the next slide, this is the site where you will go to find not just anything, jobs that we currently have open in the Maryland Department of Labor, but any state jobs within the state of Maryland, any and every department. You would go to, if you see up at the top under current opportunities, the website, www.workformaryland.com, not .gov, .com. It will take you to the government.gov site, but it's a lot easier to remember workformaryland.com than the actual technical site that it leads you to. But as you see,
I'm sorry, before we let you go, one of our viewers, Brandon Beatty, had a really, really good and important question. He wanted to know if, in fact, there were any ex-offender friendly or justice involved friendly opportunities working with the state.
Absolutely. And it really depends on a case by case basis. I would have to go in and, depend on what Brandon is looking for. Obviously, we want to make sure we get a good match for your skills and experience. But we even have reentry navigators that work with individuals who have, felonies, misdemeanors, any type of background issue that is a barrier to employment. We have special case managers that work with those individuals, and I can get you connected to the one in Baltimore City. Her name is Marshall. She would be probably the best resource to know which jobs would be appropriate within the state, which ones, depending again on what the charges are, and very individualized case by case basis. But
Brandon, I'm glad that you asked the question, because one of the things that we have to do a lot in our business roles is we have to tear down a lot of the myths. And this show has been great for getting people on here. And one of the things that I tell people, if you believe you match the skill set and you've had some justice involvement like I did when I was younger, it makes sense for you to go ahead and to shoot your shot, as we would say. You know, apply in a professional manner, you know, take responsibility for what may have happened if you get to that interview place, you know, and let people see who you are in your beautiful forward progress from what may have been in the past. But do not make the mistake of assuming at no level that you're not able to get an opportunity because of your past.
Absolutely. Don't disqualify yourself. Go out there. You said it beautifully, Marvin. And like you said, I've got stuff on my background from when I was younger and dumber.
Absolutely.
there you go. again, it is very individualized. It really depends, because obviously different charges, it can run the gamut. We could get you paired up with a reentry navigator specialist who can work with you one-on-one and go through, you know, based on your experience, your skills, your interest level, and let you know if it would be a good match. And again, like Marvin said, don't disqualify yourself. If you see something, apply for it. Let them tell you no. Don't tell yourself no. Let the employer tell you no. But hopefully they will.
Audience, you are on live with the Employee Baltimore Show. Please go to the Mayor's Office of Employment Development page and stop texting and inboxing me questions. We can actually get your questions on the screen if you go to the Baltimore Mayor's Office of Employment Development page, so we can get them answered directly by Roseanne. Roseanne, we're turning it back over to you. I keep putting my head down because people are in my phone. I'm trying to go to the broadcast. Your question may be somebody else's question.
Absolutely. And I know we have someone else, so I don't want to take up the whole time, but I can stay on if you want, to answer questions at the end. I definitely want to make sure our next guest presenter has enough time to do his thing as well.
So why don't we do this, y'all? We don't normally do this, but we're going to have a little extended commercial break.
There we go.
This commercial is going to be with our next amazing guest. How about that? Listen, Katanya, you the best booker in the world, and this show is evolving under your leadership. And because she is a real workforce partner, we're going to let Roseanne hang out because she want to stick around. And yep. What we'll do is we'll get our next guest on, and then we're going to have some more workforce conversation. And hopefully we can get people moved into this space, because if there is state job opportunity questions that you have, we want to be able to get you to get them in. But this next person is a part of a new segment that's going to be called Tasteful Thursdays. All right, put that in the comments on if you want here. Tasteful Thursdays. He is, first of all, he bald and bearded. We the best, right? And he is a chef who, as we deploy this segment of the show, it's going to be about helping us to get nutrition tips and things of that nature to help us with our health. I've been trying my best to eat right. I even brought donuts to the office today for our team and didn't eat any myself. I had the coffee, but not the donuts. All right. So we would like to bring to the stage our next guest. He's an amazing, amazing chef, and he is Chef Shipp. I don't know. Come on to the stage, brother. Chef Carl is here. I don't know with us on the regular, but I'm advocating for it. Come in on Thursday. Give us a few minutes of your time. Yes. How you doing, Thursdays, man?
I'm doing great. And yourself?
I'm doing great, man. I'm excited about this new segment because we've got to take every opportunity that we have to help people understand the necessity of being able to eat right, eat healthy. And you not only have that, but you got some positions available that you want to share. Are you the owner of the place where you are?
No, I'm actually not the owner of this restaurant. I actually own a company called Love and Happiness, which is an event hosting and party planning company. So I'm the chef behind that company. As far as employment opportunities, we have employment opportunities for servers, bartenders, dishwashers in that capacity, doing different pop-up shops that I host in the city.
So if you listen, y'all, if you're in that hospitality field, and you want to kind of, so that would be more on the part-time side, right?
Yes, yes.
If you're looking for some other opportunities, or opportunity to kind of get in and do some learning, we got them here on Tasteful Thursday. Our guy, Chef Carl, is here, but we're going to jump into what we came here to talk about. Tell the people a little bit about yourself and your passion for food and nutrition.
So my name is Chef Carl Shipp. I specialize in the cuisine of love. I create edible expressions of love. A lot of things that I do are intentional, inspired cooking. So I cook for any type of dietary restriction.
Y'all hold up. I'm sorry. I told you I'm not the conventional host, but this brother putting it down already, the cuisine of love. Y'all need, every time he say one of those fly things, y'all hashtag it in the comments. The cuisine of love. Oh my goodness. I wish I could cook. I can cook, y'all, but I don't think I'm on that cuisine of love level. Go ahead, Chef Carl.
Cooking is definitely a labor of love. And the dishes I create are inspired by the people that I cook for. So I have a large background in private chef and personal chefing, coming to the home or setting up for my clients. And then on a bigger scale, I cater larger events, banquets, weddings, and that type of thing. So some of the employment opportunities would be under that umbrella. I'm here today to highlight Tasteful Thursday and talk about a dish that I created that is for vegans. It's a vegan version of a soul food, grandma's potato salad. I put a little spin on it for some special vegans in my life. So I want to showcase that today and talk a little bit about why this is a good option. So
let's have it. You're going to make me hungry, brother.
Vegan sweet potato salad.
My goodness. Listen, I thought, Chef Carl, I thought we had done everything we could do with the sweet potato.
No.
But you just taking it. Listen, y'all, tune into the Employee Baltimore Show Tasteful Thursdays. Now, I'm going to tell you, go get his. Don't try to make this at home, especially if you ain't well. I wasn't that well-versed in the sweet potato. But tell us about that amazing dish.
So the best thing about the sweet potato is that it is a low-glycemic option. So it won't spike your blood sugar. So this is a dish that's great for anybody that has diabetes. Then as far as for the vegans, there's no traditional potato salad. When I make it, has egg in it. Vegans don't have egg or can't use regular mayonnaise. So we got some vegan mayonnaise. We got some a mix.
Cover the label up next time. We ain't giving Hellman's.
Oh, all right. That's
Chef Carl's mayonnaise, y'all. Chef Carl's vegan mayonnaise.
We got Chef Carl's seasoning that went into it.
That's okay. Right. The cuisine. I'm going to need some of that. Put the order information up there, Chef Carl.
I will. It's on the website. The website will be listed.
All right. That's what's up. Keep talking. I'm having too much.
So we have a mix of, let's see if you can get this. Mix of peppers, red onions, and then some spices. And the sweet potatoes, I boiled them. You can boil or roast them. It's better if you boil them. Roasting them like accents the sugarness. So if you're diabetic, it's better to roast them. But if the sugar isn't your issue, I mean, if you're diabetic, it's better to roast them. But if sugar isn't really an issue, it's better to roast them and caramelize the sugar in the sweet potato. And this is a side that I highlight with my menus. For my vegan clientele.
Man, vegan sweet potato salad. And I thought I've had potato salad everywhere. Y'all know I'm one of them people. I'm gonna tell y'all right off the muscle. I don't eat store-bought potato salad, and I don't eat white potato salad. You have a little yellow in your potato salad. But I gotta try this, man. How do we get to this and some of the other things that you're doing?
So, like I said, there's a restaurant that I'm associated with in Aberdeen. On Thursdays, we do a Tasteful Thursday out here. You can come and try some of my dishes in the restaurant. Or you can follow me on my webpage. First, you can follow me on Instagram at thechef83. That's D-A-C-H-E-F-83. And then my website is www.cuisineoflove. And it'll talk about different events that I'm hosting or different pop-ups that I have in the city. Then you can always order a pan of this for a function that you have, you know, baby shower, bridal wedding, any birthday party. You can order from my menu.
All right, y'all, I followed instructions. I just hit up Chef Carl Shipp on Instagram and followed him. We want y'all to be tuning in on Thursdays to get these good nutrition tips. Now, those of y'all that think you're nice with it, go ahead and try the recipe. If you listen, I'll even taste test it for you, but I want y'all to know I'm going to be honest. I'm going to be honest. Chef Carl Shipp, thank you for being with us today. Contact Chef Carl at https://cuisineoflove.com. Every time I say that name, Cuisine of Love. And listen, if you do get a chance to come back with us, man, bring more of your stuff. You got your own seasoning and some of the other things that you branded. We want, just for you being willing to come on here, share your time and the great information that you're sharing with us, I want to be able to promote your brand and some of the things that you're doing.
Thank you.
Man, it's awesome. I'm going to talk to you because I got a group of boys that I mentor, and I would love for you to be able to come and we can maybe set up a little griddle or something, and you can teach them a little something. And one of our mentors.
Absolutely.
We got to make it happen.
That's something that's dear to my heart, fatherhood, mentorship. I have 4 young sons of my own. So, yes, you set it up, I'll be there.
Oh, man. Listen, y'all. These are the kind of amazing people that are here in the Baltimore area doing great things outside. And listen, he also said that he has some opportunities. Can you tell us about those opportunities again for people who are either in the hospitality field or interested in hospitality?
So when I do my events, I utilize hosts, servers, dishwashers, cooks, training. There's opportunities to work directly with me to learn culinary arts. So we run the gamut of opportunities in the hospitality field.
And we got to get some of our youth opportunity folks at the 18 to 24 age range, those great young adults we working with, connected to that. And don't forget, Chef, when you ready to do that nice, intimate dinner for two, call Chef Carl.
Yes, sir.
If it's
yes,
couples
sir.
Night at your house and the dinner not just for two, is for four.
A couple, we can get a couple couples. yes, sir.
Listen, I'm a pastor. If you're doing your church event, you go get the mothers of the church a day off, call Chef Carl.
I appreciate that.
We
yes,
want
sir.
Y'all to support yes, Chef Carl and everything that he's doing. Great opportunities for great people. Chef Carl, I thank you for being with us today, man. I'm looking forward to talking to you more. Thank you, Katonda, for booking Chef Carl. I told y'all he bald and bearded, so he was already all right with me. That's Chef Carl Shipp, and he is at www.cuisineoflove.com. And he's can you put the Instagram up again? I already went and followed him. I want everybody else to go follow him at D-A-C-H-E-F, the Chef 83 on Instagram. Chef Carl, thank you for coming today, man.
Thank
You've been
you
a
having
great
me.
Guest. It's been fun. And we're going to talk to you more in the coming future.
All right.
Thank you, man. All right. Let's get Roseanne back up on the screen. Hopefully, we got some people on here with some great questions. If not, we just going to have a little bit more of this workforce conversation. Listen, I tell people, when you get a chance to talk shop talk with the people that really know what they're talking about, it's like when I go to the take my car to the shop, right? Now, don't get me wrong. I know brakes, I know oil change, I know pump gas, I know replace some fluids. But when they start talking about some of that stuff, I say, man, listen, hold all that. Just give me the price. But you put two mechanics together and get them to talk, and they be like they in heaven. It's the same way when I get to talk to another workforce development professional, somebody that really knows this great work that we do. Roseanne, listen, it's been an honor to have you on here today. If you wanted to share anything else with the people, we'll give you an opportunity to do that. And listen, y'all, if you or somebody that you're serving, because we get people, I saw Pivot Baltimore on here, and we got a few other folks that work in the workforce development sector. If you are working with people and you have questions about these state opportunities or anything, now's the time to shoot your jumper. Come on, talk to us, Roseanne.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, I agree. It's like you geek out when you're talking about what you love. You know, it's like your hobby, but you get to get paid for it. It's awesome. But yes, I was looking more into the reentry website, which I can put up in the chat. But now, I would
that would
definitely
be amazing.
Yeah, let me get that in there. While
we put it in the chat, we can get it up on the screen, y'all. So again, Brandon Beatty asked us about reentry stuff. And listen, y'all, we sometimes eliminate our own selves when we assume that there's no opportunity for you because you are a returning citizen. I'm not sure what lingo, justice involved. That's what we're using now. It's evolved so much over the years. If you justice involved, but don't make that assumption. Whether I found out that there are opportunities in University of Maryland Medical Center for people that have been justice involved, y'all. So don't assume. You've got to shoot your shot. Come on, Roseanne.
Amen. I'm loving that. You're preaching. You might not be in church, but you're preaching today. But it's absolutely true. And I'm guilty of it as well. It's very true what they say about you can be your own worst enemy. You know, don't discredit yourself no matter what has been done in the past. We all have good skills. We, especially, you know, if you've learned from it, you've moved on, you know, a lot of times that's what teaches us our lessons, the school of hard knocks. So as long as you've learned your lesson and you're ready to move forward, we have opportunities for you. And when you search in the state job board, the www.workformaryland.com, there is no indication of criminal background. There is a background check to become a state employee. Once you get a job offer and you accept it, there is a background check. And again, we can coach you through how to address that through our career centers, through our career navigators. But again, like Marvin said, don't disqualify yourself.
Yes.
Because it's all on a case-by-case basis. And sometimes it really doesn't even matter if it was, you know, ages ago. So, or if it was something minor that the law has changed, like marijuana is one of the things that has been a big issue in not just the state, but in the city. Decriminalization. So again, you know, something that you might think is a big deal might not be a big deal anymore. Or, you know, I don't want to keep...
I believe more people disqualify themselves by not applying than people are rejected who actually apply. Because I'm going to tell you, from being in this business, there are people who are looking for either a skilled workforce or they're looking for a prepared workforce. You might say, what's the difference? The difference in that prepared workforce, there are people who are ready on the soft skill side. Some employees just say to me, man, listen, I need somebody who's going to show up every day, enthusiastic about the opportunity, ready to learn and to move forward with their life. We have got to stop shutting ourselves down by not even giving ourselves an opportunity and trying.
Yes, absolutely. And we, you know, where our goal, we are very diverse within the state, Maryland Department of Labor and the state in general, and we're looking to be more diverse. And the individuals that we work with, we like to have folks that have that experience working with those folks, if that makes sense. For
Pivot
example,
Pivot Baltimore has a question for you. If I have a customer that wants to apply on the state level, who should we send the resume to?
You can send it to me. I would need to know what job. If it's the trade job I was talking about, that one, long story short, it had been posted. They didn't get enough qualified applicants. So now they're accepting resumes through email. But you can still send me the resume. If it's a job that is currently posted, the candidate will still have to go in and apply to be officially considered for the position, but I can still get you connected with somebody that can walk you through the process and in applying for that position.
That's awesome, y'all. Before we wrap this puppy up, do we have any more questions? If we don't have any more questions, I want to thank you, Roseanne. This has been amazing, and I'm sure this won't be the last time. I think what we need to do, I don't know, Katanya, you the producer. I just have some ideas. We might even can carve out a regular small segment where we can talk to Roseanne about what's happening in the state or at the state level. Maybe every other show or something. I don't know. Roseanne is just so easy to talk to, and it's great when you get to hang out with people who are truly passionate about this work, because I think that's what really ties the members of the Mayor's Office of Employment Development together with the people at Dollar. Even going back, like I said, to great people we've worked with in the past, like Lisa Nash, when we know that we're all in and the common goal is about bridging these gaps. That's what we're here to do, y'all. It is not about us. We are chosen few, a very unique industry of people. You won't find us everywhere, but the one thing you will find is a people that are passionate about bridging the gap, whether the people work we're doing is in businesses or, okay, the producer has approved. Roseanne can come on each month. We'll work out the gate, but y'all be looking for when we have our state check-in with Roseanne. But whether it's on the side working with businesses who are people that are looking to expand, grow, fill in positions that they have available, or the people side, which is the job seeker, which I've always loved to do, literally changing the social economic dynamic of people's lives and helping people to move forward, especially in a town like Baltimore, where the good work and the good things seem to fall off the grid. I'm waiting for Fox 45 to report on this show. I'm waiting for Channel 2 News to come and say, we want to talk about that event that y'all have going on. I'm waiting to see these things happen because it's a lot of great work that's happening in Baltimore. It's life-changing work. Thank you again, Roseanne, for being with us. I want to thank Chef Carl Shipp, who you'll be seeing again, for checking in on our first Tasteful Thursday. I got to shout out our producer and booker and all of that pre-gamer and tell me what to do, when to do, how to do it, the wonderful and awesome Miss Katanya Lester. I want to shout out the Mayor's Office of Employment Development. And I want to talk about something that we don't talk about a lot. We have an amazing group of leaders in this agency that are forward thinking, very progressive, and very aggressive in understanding that we have got to do this work the right way. We have got to do it the right way. We're in meetings where the conversation is around economic justice, social change, making sure that there's access for everybody who wants to be in a better position as it pertains to their employment or career. These are aggressive conversations. Jason Perkins calling Mackenzie Garvin, Helani, Yvette Clark, all of these amazing people who are doing this great work at that level. You see us when you come in the centers. You see us when on the Employee Baltimore show. But the people who are at the highest level making this happen, I want to salute them today. I want to thank them for the great work that they're doing to make sure that this agency isn't stuck in 1985 workforce development, but that we have a very progressive and very aggressive approach to making sure the residents of the city of Baltimore are moving forward. Mr. Craig Lewis, people whose names you rarely see. And if you saw them in the center, you wouldn't even know what they're there for. They're the unsung heroes. And I want to personally say thank you for the great work that you do to make sure that this agency continues to move forward, making a difference, a relevant difference, a timely difference, an innovative difference. Because without you guys, we wouldn't be able to do the great work that we do. Thank y'all for joining the Employee Baltimore show today. I'm looking forward to you checking in next Thursday at 1 p.m. I'll be right here. Every once in a while we have a guest host, but I believe I'll be here with you next week with more exciting news about what's happening in workforce development in Baltimore and with some more amazing guests. Listen, if you are looking for an opportunity here in Baltimore, the Mayor's Office of Employment Development is looking for you. With a focus on economic justice, we are committed to building a workforce system that actually works. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time.